Hello, 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 and welcome to this evening's Grand Prix, ladies and gentlemen. You join myself, Lemony Tang, in the commentary booth. As always, it's an absolute pleasure to be here for the Prospects eRacing League. It's round six, it's tier one PC from Miami. So, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a wet and wild one here this evening. The rain is absolutely pouring out of the heavens. And I say that's going to be some good news to them boats in that fake harbour there down towards turn 6, 7 and 8. But as the cars get on track now, they need their flippers instead of their full wets this evening, it looks like. But they'll see how they get on, and hopefully for the race it's going to be a dry one. But it's a packed grid here this evening. We got 17 cars. It's a fantastic track to be here. The Miami Grand Prix 2022 was brand new on the calendar. It's nice to see Formula One visiting new places, new challenges for everyone as well, and it's great to be here as always. So as we look here at Bushy Ants in the Alpine, we'll have a look at this track. It's 19 turns, ladies and gentlemen. As I said there, it is 5.4 kilometers, 3.3 miles long. Max Verstappen is the current race winner around here. But that race was full of incidents and accidents. We had Mick Schumacher and Vettel coming together at turn one, costing Mick a potential points-paying position that day. And then Gasly and Lando having a bit of a whoop-de-woo as well on the back straight. But as Bushy Ants navigates that chicane there very nicely, it is a very tricky track out there indeed. As we say there, it's 19 corners, but it feels as if they don't really get much of a break. This back straight is the only time they get to catch their breath around here. As we jump on board with the Alpine driver, we'll ride on board for the rest of this, for the start of this lap now. Let's see how he gets on through the final corner. Flat out in these Formula One cars, but it's going to be interesting to see how the grip stays with the wet here this evening. Down into turn one, hard on the brakes. Watch that apex as well, because you need to compromise that into turn three. On that curve a little bit, nearly lost the rear, but he kept it nicely. Around now towards turn four now, hard braking into a sweeping left right. Well, not hard braking, really just a dab of the brakes, I should really say. Now into turn six, 7 and 8, just one never-ending triple apex left-hander before finally onto the back straight here. Now turn 8, a little bit of wheel spin, even in 6th gear I think it was there. Unbelievable stuff on the intermediates as well at the moment, so we'll have a look and see who else has any wets. No, it's just full intermediates for everyone at the moment, so fair play to everyone feeling as if it's good tire to be on. Now into this very tight and twisty midsection here, coming through the chicane bits, 11, 12, 13, unbelievable, these cars just do not feel right at all. I thought he was going into the wall almost there, I got myself lost, I'm sure you guys did too at home. But as he comes onto the back straight now, absolutely flat out, down towards turn 17, a fantastic passing opportunity in the race. And not so much in qualifying, you want to give yourself a bit of space to the cars in front. But nicely done as well, kept it, oh, a little bit of contact, didn't invalidate, that's the most important thing. And loosey-goosey on the rear as well, this is going to be challenging through here on the wet. And he's into the divisional pole on a 1:34.7. But everyone is out there at the moment, it's a short qualifying. They need to be having a lot of fuel in these cars as well. We have a look at El Brando back here in the area. They need to have a lot of fuel in these cars right now, get themselves comfortable with this track, get themselves comfortable with the grip levels, and build up that momentum. That's the most important thing. Get that momentum, that car and track confidence, and then go for it near the end. Leo Lund into first position there in a 1:34.6 as well. So, not too bad for the guys, it seems to be. That's the aim of the game. Just keep your car in on the track at the moment, out of the wall, and try and make it towards the end of qualifying. A very busy track at the moment, only one car in the pit lane, that is Nick, but we will see him out on track very shortly, one would assume. So El Brando is on a bit of a back off lap there, not quite on it. Sushi Trash, how's he getting on? Seems to be. Have a look at now, nicely going through turn 16 under the back straight. Easy to lose some time there, and you carry that loss of time all the way down the back straight. So very smooth operator onto the throttle there. As he comes down the back straight now, what can he do? No one around him, absolutely fantastic. Concentration into the braking zone. Ooh, a little bit deep, but he kept it in. Nicely done. Found the grip. Definitely found the grip on exit on the throttle application. As he comes through the final corner now, that rear end trying to come around, but it doesn't. The 136 overshoots the trash. And he keeps our lift for the time being. Nick still in the pit lane, but he is coming out onto the track right now, ladies and gentlemen. Nimble, one of the only cars out there not setting a lap time so far. Clement Pheasant is also out there. He's just coming through the second last corner now. What can he do? Yellow flags out there indicating that somebody has had a bit of a misdemeanor or a bit of a mishap. 137.7, getting himself grounded at the moment more than anything else. Nimble still out there on his fast lap. John Mazur, one of the contenders you would want to think here this evening, still hasn't set a lap time either. Yellow flags are still flying out there. Cars perhaps getting out of the way more than anything else. As we have a look at Nimble coming through the last corner effectively, but not the wet. It is very difficult through the last two corners as well. He's in the ninth position with that effort. Very good stuff. Everyone's still on a flyer out there. I don't know who to quite have a look at. Have a look at John Mazur here. A lot of rear wheel spin there. I could feel it. And you could see it as well. You could hear it. But he's navigated it nicely. The sun is starting to come out, everyone. I'm not quite sure if it's going to dry up here for qualifying. It could perhaps by the end of it. And John Mazur into fourth position. Fantastic stuff. Dangerous is out there in the Haas. How can he do? He's in second at the moment. Going through fast left right of turn 4 and 5 into 6 and 7 he goes. There's that harbour there as well. We're seeing the boats will be nice and wet here in that harbour. One that you wouldn't really normally be saying, but it's a dry harbour. Interesting back straight. One of the back straights here. Flat out in these F1 cars, but a bit of a blind corner or two. You wouldn't want to come around there and find someone parked in the middle of the track or anything like that. But with the talent of these guys, you would expect that it would be no issues. Coming into now again, turn 12, 13, 14, 15. These kind of Mickey Mouse corners, I don't know. Apparently there's a regulation that stipulates how that corner has to be set up for the height over the bridge there. Why don't I just extend the track or something? I'm not quite sure. You know what I mean? Dig under and don't know. You know what I mean? They lay down loads of tarmac for the castle section in Azerbaijan. I'm sure they could come up with some sort of solution. It's F1, for crying out loud. They don't need to be doing that Mickey Mouse chicane. Anyway, oh, dangerous! I can't believe it! Did you see that swippity swap as he's seeing through the corners? We said it was treacherous out there. He just shows us how it is done. Well, not meant to be done through the second last corner or last corner. Easily flat out in the dry, but not in the wet. He's very lucky to get away with that one. A bit of a tank slapper, but he's still in qualifying. That's the main thing. Leon Lund is still your provisional pole sitter with 9 minutes and 10 seconds and odds on the clock here. Everyone would want to start thinking about their second run, and it is definitely starting to look a lot more better with them clouds around the back straight here. Turn 6, 7 and 8. Ooh, little bit loosey on the throttle there, I tell you now. Keeps it flat though, fair play to him. That's what you like to see. Have a look at the telemetry as well. No hiding here in the commentary booth. Absolutely brilliant stuff. Just trying to say hello to everyone in the chat there. How you doing? Don't forget to follow, like and subscribe to my own channel as well. But yeah, man, this is the Prospects E-Racing League. It's round 6. It's qualifying for the Miami Grand Prix. Ladies and gentlemen, it's fantastic to be here as we look at Leo Lund, the provisional pole sitter. Is he going for another lap here? He's definitely out there on some nice worn intermediates. The top layer of rubber has come off and he's trying to get them inter slicks perhaps. But he's got a 133.9 on the board. This track is definitely improving. And I don't know. I don't know, is it going to dry up? Can you throw a set of soft, sticky softs on for the end of qualifying? 7 minutes and 40 odd seconds. The time is ticking. The rain is slightly still coming down. But with these gigantic Hoovers, no lie about it, ladies and gentlemen, 17 cars going around the racetrack can make a dry line appear very quick indeed. As you see, everyone getting out of the way of each other there. Fair play to everyone. Nice heads up driving. Bushy Ant is coming around that corner now. How is he getting on the throttle now? I think he might be on one. Definitely trying to keep the head down, the slipstream down the back straight here. I wonder what kind of wing settings and all he has. Does he have a dry setup or a wet setup? Ooh, is he gonna lift off? No. Clipping down the back straight, I think that was. So that's a little bit of a telltale. Just don't get tilking, that's what I say. Oh, look at that, there's an Alfa Romeo with no front wing, unfortunately for them, trying hard. If you don't come back with the steering wheel in your hand, ladies and gentlemen, from time to time, you can't really say you're trying hard enough now, can you? But anyway, no harm, no foul. Bushy Ant's down towards the last corner now, a little bit wide of the apex, trying to use a wet line perhaps, and he thinks he's coming in. Yes, he is indeed. He is indeed coming in, nicely done. Dangerous, back out. It's okay, it's only dangerous. We're just on board on them, it's fine. So as dangerous comes into the left and the right for the rear end there, keeps it nicely done, under control. Very nice indeed. True current seven now. Down the back straight now. In the Haas driver, can he navigate it nicely? New intermediates. It's still raining a bit out there, so I don't see this track perhaps drying up as much as we would like. Nonetheless, still very tricky conditions out there. 100%. This is the kind of moment, ladies and gentlemen, where the track is a little bit greasy, perhaps. It's not as wet in some places as you really want for them tyres to be able to get rid of that water. And a kind of a top layer of sheen gets onto the surface. And it can just make the track really hard and the grip really, really difficult to find where it is. But as he comes down the back straight now, all he needs to do is concentrate on the braking zone. Nice. Into the hairpin. Very good. Watch the left, right. Still a little bit squirrely, but he keeps it in nicely. Foot to the floor. And as he comes across the line, he is improved. He definitely has improved. He's only about a tenth shy there, but he's still second position. Good effort from Dangerous, I have to say. But Nimble is into fourth in the Aston Martin. That's a very good effort. Look at this. He's definitely going to start drying up here. Oh, what did these strategists do? I'm not quite sure if it was Scuderia and it was the real live situation. I'd say full wets, definitely. Definitely, but anyone else would be thinking of them nice, soft, slick tires. You can light them up, keep them in temperature. You could get away if it's just on that. Look at that, a little bit of a dry line down here. It definitely is indeed. Well, if I was talented enough, I'd definitely be thinking of that one, ladies and gentlemen. So we'll see what these tier one guys can do. But for the time being, I think it still is a little bit wet. Oh no, Nimble into the wall. You heard the crunch. We've seen it happening. I wonder if he's had his floor damage or that one. That would be an absolute disaster for his qualifying. But he might have got away with it. But not good for the lap time anyway. It isn't validated. But there we go. John Mazer's on one now as well in sixth position. Everyone in there. Look at that. Half the grid in the pits at the moment. Let's see what tires. There is people out on softs. Who is out there on softs? We have El Brando's the first one out there on softs. We got Nick out on a set of inters though. I don't know if that's going to be the right call here, especially with 3 minutes on odd left on the clock here. The track is only going to keep drying. Oh, John Mazer, a lot of wheel spin there out of that corner. But as he heads his way down the back straight, I don't know, would you? You'd have to abandon ship for this one if you want to come in for them slicks. It's looking dry. It definitely is looking dry. We're going to jump onto El Brando momentarily. We'll see what John Mazer does. No, he continues. John Mazer continues. What kind of a lap time is John Mazer now going to post onto the board? A 1. Oh, look at that. A 1:33.7. He's in the pole position, ladies and gentlemen. And I think it's the switcheroo now. I think the qualifying times are going to tumble. We've got Brando out on a set of slicks. He's the first car on a set of slicks. Let's have a look here. It's very important to see how he gets on. How is he going to get on here? He's the one in the pound seat for now. Is the track dry enough? That's the question. We will soon find out as he crosses the timing beam and he's onto his flying lap here into turn one, hard onto the brakes, down into second gear. Very nice indeed. Through the left right, might need to be a little bit hesitant, but there definitely is a dry line. You can 100% see it now. The sun is shining. He's backed off right there. So he's backed off. We have Sinner. I think he's the next one on the lap at the moment. He's just crossed the line on a set of softs. Let's have a look how he gets on with these. Has he fired up in front, the front end, or is he going for another warm-up lap? Let's have a look here to sector one momentarily now. We'll see who gets on through the left and right. Oh, Lord almighty. Nice line. Look at that. Absolutely fantastic. And he's up by a second. Nearly 2 seconds. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. DRS is enabled as well. So this is here. This is what it's all going to be all about now. We're on board a Sinner at the moment. But these lap times will be coming ticking fast. Now, John Mazer's out there on intermediates. I think he's after... Not, he might have done the Ferrari strategy here. He doesn't have time to come in for softs. So what can everyone else do? True. The left, right, and then the left here again. Turn 14, 15, and 16. Yellow flags in front, but Sinner's not going to worry about that too much. Can he pick up a slipstream from the car in front, who's weaving down the front, down the back straight? Do they realise he's on a lap here? You don't want to be coming into this kind of traffic. He is not good, really. God, he's wide as well. The Williams in front definitely didn't help him out there. But what kind of a lap time can he do? There's a Ferrari spun around there. That might be El Brando. As he crosses the line, Sinner's into pole position, provisional pole on a 1:32.9. But it's kicking off right now. Nick is on intermediates as well. He's out there throwing himself out there. Who'll be on board? We'll have a look at Leo Lund or Dangerous. Dangerous is about to cross the line. He's just crossed the line into fifth. But people are still having some issues out there. Sushi Trash in a 1:30.7. Fantastic stuff from himself. Who else is going to be out there? Arrows. We'll see what Arrows can do. He's definitely one of the protagonists here this evening. Leo Lund is still out there as well. I think he's just in front. He might be just on the lap as well himself. But Arrows was last week's pole position winner. What can Arrows do here? It's going to be very interesting. He's a little bit wide. Look at that. He might be losing some time. Not the cleanest of sections here for Arrows. What can Leo Lund do? Leo Lund is just in front. No, Leo Lund is behind. So that's good news. So we'll jump back on board at Arrows. Lap times are starting to come in. Bushy Ants on a 1:29.8. Fantastic lap times. They're starting to tumble now. Squares is in second at the moment on a 1:30.5. But their lap times are finished. Their qualifying is over. Who else is out there that can spoil their day? I think Arrows is going to be coming across the line momentarily. Clement Pheasant is just in front, ladies and gentlemen. Where is he going to jump up the board? Clement is into sixth position. Great stuff. Arrows into second, but Mitchick's Murk literally just right behind pips him to pole position. What can Leo Lund do now in the McLaren down the back straight? As we have a look here, look at that. Dangerous into pole position now in a 1:20.5. Fantastic. Knocks a whole half a second off pole position. What can Lund do now as he crosses the line? Not quite sure. It jumped away. He got first, ladies and gentlemen. Leo Lund is your pole position winner. Absolutely brilliant. Unbelievable lap time from Leo Lund. We have Dangerous there in second. And then we've got Mitchick's Murk in third. Oh, what a fantastic qualifying. So that's Nimble there. Leo Lund in first, Dangerous in second. Mitchick's Murk is in third. Then we have Nimble in fourth. We have Arrows in 5th, Bushi Hansen 6th, Squares in 7th, Sushi Trash in 8th, Shinner in 9th, Clement Pheasant in 10th, John Mazur in 11th, Nick in 12th, Damien in 13th, Damien in 14th, Tifa Real in 15th, El Brando in 16th, and Got Spooked is 17th. I nearly didn't quite get that in. And we've got two people with the same name. Interesting stuff. But brilliant qualifying. I cannot believe it. Absolutely amazing. Fair play to Leo Lund at that last lap. He was the last one almost across the line to start his lap and to finish his lap. And he pips them to pole position with Dangerous there in second. Absolutely great stuff from himself. I'm sure the likes of everyone behind there would have, could have, should have thought they might have had it, but they didn't quite have it. So as we wait for the drivers now to load up into the garages, there's only one thing on their mind, and that has to be turn one and the rest of the rest of the race. What's happening in qualifying stays in qualifying. Points and prizes are now in the race. So they've set their tire strategy, their fuel strategy. Are we expecting some safety cars? We'll find out sooner rather than later. And to concentrate about turn one. If they can go up the inside, around the outside perhaps, but they don't want to be going into the back of someone, that's for sure. So I don't think there's any warm-up lap again, ladies and gentlemen. We're just going to wait for these lights to go out. We got 5 and away they go. It seems to be a decent enough start there from first, second and third. But as they start to come down towards turn one, Leo Lund is in first position. There's an Alfa Romeo, launches it up the inside, makes tremendous contact. Dangerous as it's being spun around as well in the Haas. I didn't quite catch it there with a comment. We've definitely seen it on the stream as they all start to come through. The left and the right to turn 4 and 5 are coming up now. They're 3 wide into there. I don't know how they're going to quite get around it. Aston Martin there in losing a bit of front wing as we jump towards the front of the field. Now it's Leo Lund still in the lead with Mitchick Smirk in second. Then we got Bushi Hansen in third, Nimble in fourth, Sushi Trash is in fifth. I think he one of them Aston Alphas was definitely up the inside. Might be visiting the stewards room after this one for sure. Nick and Co going side by side, is it? No, it's the Aston Martin and Squares and Dame. Whoa. Alpine, I should say. As they all start to file themselves into the hard braking zone there, it seems as if Clement Pheasant and Co were side by side. What's going to happen down into the left-handers? They need to give each other space. Clement is still there. Oh, lads, what is this? People being fed into the wall almost. There's an AlphaTauri after resetting. But as they come onto the back straight now, there's a virtual safety car, ladies and gentlemen. A VSC is being deployed. It seems to be getting a little bit too tight in there for some of them guys, that is for sure. We'll have a quick look at the telemetry now and we'll get the details of what kind of tires are people on. Mostly are on hards. That's a very interesting one. Nick and Damien sort of passing each other under the VSC. Not really what you want to see. But there we go, they're coming into the pit lane, trying to take advantage of an early stop, perhaps get off them hards onto a nice set of mediums. VSD is still deployed. We have no news of race control when it's going to be coming in, but we'll have a look. The green flag is waving now. Nobody gets a penalty either, so that's pretty handy with that one. Fair play to everyone. But the green flag waves again. The racing resumes. Arrows is on a set of sauce. We'll have a look at him because we'll expect him to fly up through this field, especially with some of the pace he's shown in the past. Look at that, different tyres up the inside. Absolutely brilliant. But the Williams fights back on the outside, swoops it back around. Great defensive work from John Mazur. Meister and you're battling down the back straight now. No DRS quite yet, but a bit of DRS deployment as the Ferrari swoops out the slipstream around the outside. Done deal before the braking zone. What can the Williams do? He settles in. They settle in. Very good stuff indeed. But that is Arrows using the superior grip of that soft tyre to get the tyre advantage, the grip advantage. And he's made his way up into ninth position now. So let's see how everyone gets on. We'll have a look here at the position changes. Arrows is down 3. That's a very interesting start. So he must have got clipped around perhaps as he comes up, slipstreams behind the Red Bull, and he makes his way past Damien. Is he going to try for... Oh, Damien back up the inside! Ooh, definitely just showing a nose, giving Arrows something to think about. But Arrows was unfazed. Kept his line, kept his braking zone, and he was good to go. Look at this, he's onto the back of the Alpine now as well, showing how fantastic them new slick tyres, them softs, are really coming into his aid now. To the advantage is Arrows, but he does have to come onto a set of hards later on, which could be his downfall. So different strategies for guys out there. Arrows is still down one from the start, but Bushy Ants is up three, Sivji Trash is up three, and as we've seen, unfortunately, Dangerous down in 11th after losing 9 positions. Not good. But Damien in 8th has gained 6 positions. There is only 2 Damiens. Alright. Damien Inception in here in the commentary booth. But we will persevere. Keep going, as they say. Oh, Dangerous and Clement side by side. Damn, down into the hairpin. Dangerous trying to swoop it in there. He gets it done. Clement coming under increasing pressure now from El Brando in 12th position. So a bit of field spread starting to happen here. The DRS is going to definitely help a few of these guys close up down the back straight. As we have a look, it is indeed. Squares is going to be battling Arrows into the braking zone. No, but John Mazur and Damien are side by side into there. Ooh, through the exit, very close. It's very easy to feed a car into the wall. If it was online multiplayer lobbies, you'd definitely do the move. Or otherwise, somebody would do it to you. But no, we encourage very clean racing here in the Prospecty Racing League. And that is exactly what we get week in, week out. These guys are hundreds and thousands of seconds between each other. We've seen it in qualifying, and we're seeing it here in the race again. They're literally cigarette paper beside each other. But they're making the move stick, and they're keeping themselves out of trouble. So far, so good. And that's what we like to see. It's a fantastic race at the moment. We'll have 4 out of 29. It's really developing. We'll have a look at the front leaders now here at the moment, because Michik Smurk has not been able to break away from Michik. Leo Lund has not been able to break away from Michik Smurk in second. He's within a second of the DRS zone there. Leo Lund, 6.8, 7.4, whatever it is. It's within a second. Bushy Ants there in third is holding on strong to a solid podium position for now. We have Nimble there in fourth. Sushi Trash there is coming under increasing pressure of Arrows. Arrows and them softs will definitely be feeling a bit sooner rather than later. I think that might be Clement. Clement has had an old loop-the-loop, I think it was indeed. But as you see, Arrows pulls out a slipstream. Sushi Trash doesn't really do much about it. And he's up the inside. Very nicely done. Them soft tires really showing the advantage at the moment, but a little bit loose there on power, so he might be starting to feel a bit as he sets the fastest lap. But what do I know in the commentary booth? Who knows? But anyway, Michik Smurk is definitely closing this gap to the race leader here. We'll have a look at this battle. It's within 0.5 of a second and a little bit over sometimes. So as they come through turn 6, 7, and 8, the boats will be having a fantastic view here of these guys. They come onto the back straight now, turns 8, 9, and 10 technically, but they're mostly straight, let's be honest here. True, turn 9 and 10, they go into the braking zone now at turn 11. Does he pop out at the last second? He might be thinking about it. Oh, he closes, but he didn't do it, unfortunately for everyone there. I think, who's that around? Oh, that might be El Brando. Yeah, that was El Brando's there, side by side. Whoa, what is this? A little bit of dodge down the back straight. Oh no, that's into the braking zone. All right. I thought they were all trying to break each other. They all went for it. So look at this massive battle here from John Mazur Squares, Damien and Dangerous, all within a couple of tenths of each other. Absolutely fantastic. As the race leaders are coming there side by side down the back straight now. The DRS being used to full advantage, and Leo Lund has no answer. Not into the braking zone either. And the Michik Smurk makes the move. Absolutely great stuff. As we concentrate our efforts now towards this monumental battle here for 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. A little bit of weaving down the straight trying to break slipstreams, but it doesn't quite work out. And they're down into the braking zone now as well. How do they get themselves on the exit? They all switch around. Look at that fantastic stuff from John Mazur. He done it very nicely indeed. Executed it perfectly. Can he defend the inside into turn 1? No, he can't. And Squares goes up the inside, says thank you very much, and he makes the move stick. Fantastic maneuver for 7th position there. Can everyone behind? Yes, they are indeed. They're side by side again. see how they get themselves sorted out through the lefts and the rights, turn 4-5, then into the 6-7, left-handers, oh look at this, dangerous, trying to look the inside, he makes a move, oh no, the red bull behind it, Damien loses it, unfortunately under throttle application, the tyres may be starting to scream a little bit here, but these guys are literally nose to tail, as they come through the back straight here, 9 and 10, towards the braking zone at turn 11. What can they do? They're nearly three wide into here. Yes, they are, nearly, almost. And they do keep it together. Fantastic. So if Damien had nowhere to go, he just got himself... Whoa, a little bit of contact there between Damien and Cole. But yeah, Damien had nowhere to go. Two cars side by side in front of him. Didn't want to make it three wide. Very good choice for now. It's lap 6 at 29. And you'd swear it was the last lap for these guys. They come back onto the back straight here. We'll have a look at the race leaders. They're side by side. Ho-ho! So we're going to stay on board of this one because this could be a change in the race lead. The McLaren goes for the outside towards turn one. The DRS is wide open and he makes the move stick. Fantastic stuff. So the battle rages once more for the race lead as we cut back now towards this battle between... No way. John Mazer, Squares and all. They've actually kind of settled themselves out. No good. Oh, there's an Aston Martin. Nimble has spun it. I can't believe it. We've seen it just as I was scrolling through. And he gets back around. Yes, he does indeed, but not good for himself. Track marshal's doing well. Yellow flags are waving. And we're back to green flag, but not a good evening for Nimble. He's going to have to wait for a safety car now. And look at his squares getting held up now, perhaps, from the Aston Martin. Through the left-handers they go. And it's status quo there for them. So good stuff. Mitchick Smirk is 4 tenths behind the race leader. Can he do anything down the backs right now? Needs to get a good run. Look at these lines. Very good stuff from these guys. Just really gliding over them curves. And easy on the power throttle. Yes, he's good stuff. He's within 5 tenths. So is that enough, ladies and gentlemen? We will soon find out. Down towards the braking zone they go. The DRS is wide open. He's not using the slipstream. Ooh, definitely just... The McLaren in front showing his intent. He's like, if you go for it, I'm blocking it. So status quo once again as they make their way onto the front straight now. Leo Lund is trying to stretch his legs, but Mitchick Smirk is still right there within him, within that second. And there's status quo once again for the race. But we'll have a look. Where is the nice battle now at the moment? Nick and Cole are about 8 tenths off each other, aren't they? Down under the back straight. Yes, they are indeed. Little bit spread out there. Dangerous is on the back of Sushi Trash. Yes, indeed. Yes, he is indeed. Look at this. So he's trying to get up the inside. What can he do? A little bit of space given. Minimal, but enough is given. Oh, through the left of... Oh, no! Contact is made! I'm not quite sure where the Alfa Romeo thought that Haas was meant to go. He was definitely there legitimately. And unfortunately for Dangerous, he's being spun around yet again from someone else in this race. So, not a good one for Dangerous, but very good stuff. We see it time and time again with these guys. And something, unfortunately, can give in motorsport. And that was just one of them incidences. But that's why we love it so much. As... John Mazer, Squares and Co. come down into the hairpin now as well. They're starting to get held up behind Sushi Trash. Leo Lund in the lead has gained 8 tenths, so we won't worry about that too much right now. Mitchick Smirk is still in the DRS zone because they make their way out of the last corner now shortly. These guys make their way onto the back straight. DRS for the two guys behind. John Mazer is going to get a double slipstream here. How can they do it down into the braking zone? Might be on a bit of an ERS dump. John Mazer has no ERS left. That's the problem with him. Squares is 22%. Oh, it is. Sushi Trash is a good bit. That's what you want. Especially when you're leading a bit of a pack like this. The pace underneath these drivers, let it be known to everyone out there, they are absolutely fantastic. Really, they really are up there with some of the world's greatest here in the Prospect Z Racing League. The PC Tier 1 is no exception. You give them their day, they'll take anyone on, I guarantee it, as they go through turn 4 and 5, a little bit wide there, the hard tyres perhaps, just after starting to give up their best right now, and they need to settle into that rhythm, as we always constantly say here in the commentary booth, to settle into that rhythm, tick them laps away. But the action has just been jammers for this Miami Grand Prix, and it doesn't seem to be relenting anytime soon, as John Mazur in square still has the DRS coming down the back straight now towards turn 11. John Mazur doesn't know what to do into the braking zone. He decides to stick back in behind, but this fight still rages here for 5th, 6th and 7th position. What can they do through the left and right of 14, 15 and the left again at 16 under the back straight? Oh, no way. Sushi Trash had an awful run out of there, so the DRS is going to be a plenty for these two cars behind. How is it going to be down into the braking zone here? We'll find out. I'm sure Trash is on the DRS dump as they come down here. DRS wide open, is it? No, not really. I'm not quite sure. Interesting. But they all concertina up into the braking zone and pull away out of here as well. There's a yellow flag, sector one. Oh, that's Mitchick Smurk. Mitchick Smurk has had a bit of an issue out there, ladies and gentlemen. He's had a spin. I can't believe it. Mitchick Smurk has had a spin. He's out a second at the moment. Dangerous and Arrows. Oh, no, I think Arrows is in the pit lane. So Mitchick Smurk has spun out a second into turret. He's lucky he gathered it up and didn't lose any front wing. He seemed to be okay, but then tires must be crying. Hot, hot, hot out there this evening. Nimble goes to a new fastest lap on a 130.2. Look at this, though. John Mazur pushing super hard behind these two cars. It's a fantastic battle. Coming out of turn 8 now, towards turn 9 and 10, down the back straight here. One of the back straights, I should say. What are they going to do? Around the outside, it goes Sushi. Sorry, Squares on Sushi Trash. He pops out of the slipstream, but down into the braking zone. Sushi Trash launches it back up in the inside. How did they get on through the right-hander? And that's a fantastic maneuver from Squares. Oh no, Mitchick Smurk, he tapped him. John Mazur, I can't believe it. He tapped Sushi Trash around, and that is an absolute disaster. Obviously non-intentional, but that is a disaster there. Sushi Trash is in sixth. John Mazur did well to try and give that position back. I feel for that one. I can't believe it. Yellow flags are sector two as well. Oh, look at this. Who's this? Dangerous. And Sushi Trash are side by side down into the braking zone here. Nicely done. Nicely done from Dangerous. So I think people's tires are starting to give up the ghost here. I think that might have been Arrows who had spun. I'm not sure. Arrows or Brando. There's a big train behind Brando here. But that's coming down into the braking zone. Look at that. Oh, it was that Nick trying it up the inside. But he's going to lose the position here. Yes, he does indeed. So this is absolutely rage central. Down towards the back of the back here. Towards turn one they go. How are they going to navigate it here? That is 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th, 14th. All within one camera angle, ladies and gentlemen. Absolutely brilliant. Look at this. Absolutely amazing driving from these guys. So close together, it's unbelievable how they can find themselves like this sometimes. As they go through turns 4 and 5, trying to keep it with the cars in front. Very nice indeed, a little bit wide there, might get a bit of a penalty with that one. Trying to apply the throttle here as well, Nimble up the inside of the McLaren. Very good stuff, Clement Pheasant knows he's there. But as they reach the back straight now, the DRS is wide open for Bowen over half. Sushi Trash, 5 second penalty, not good for him. Speed corner cutting for 5 seconds, is it? Or three? I'm not quite sure. Maybe my eyes are playing tricks. It's a 5 second penalty. Okay. That's weird. Oh, look at that Clement Pheasant. Oh no, Damien's around in the Mercedes in the background there. Clement Pheasant had an absolute tank slapper. He saved the very good stuff from himself. But this battle up in front rages now. Nimble, double DRS here with his teammate as they pull out to try and pass the car in front. What are they going to do? Not quite down into the braking zone. They kind of concertina all back up again. Don't really know what to do. He's up the inside though. He'll switch a real great stuff. But he gets blocked by the Ferrari. Look at that. I can't believe it. He had it. And then he had to let go of it. But he's done the L switcheroo again. And his teammate got spooked. Is Mare perhaps not fighting it as much as he normally would? Oh, no, wait, he is. Look at this. They're side by side through there. Okay. So the elbows are out for these guys. Nimble has made the move. Stick coming down into turn 4 and 5. But the teammates weren't really working with each other too much. As El Brando is struggling here in the Ferrari up in front. I believe the Aston's up the inside already. Yes, he is. And that is another move made by Nimble. But coming onto the back straight here, the Ferrari might decide to have a little poke out at the last second. Let's see how they get on down into the braking zone here, the slipstream central. He's popping out. DRS is wide open, so not the greatest of strategies from Nimble. And the Ferrari is right back up into 10th position, but he outbrakes himself. These guys are costing each other a tremendous amount of time. I think Clement is just giving Nick an old tap around. And the Aston Martin finally makes a stick around the outside. Great stuff. El Brando succumbs to the Nimble's pressure with that one. And that's a fantastic maneuver from Nimble. I'm sure there's a bit of a tire advantage there. Yeah, Nimble's on four. Lap all soft. Here's Clement. Oh, Clement. And Nick has given Clement the old wibbly wobbly down the straight, saying he wasn't happy with that one. But that's motor racing. Who is that there side by side? Ooh, El Brando got spooked. El Brando's coming in. He's decided to cry enough is enough on their mediums. John Mazer is going to be making moves now on squares. What can he do? Onto the back straight now they go. DRS wide open. Not much DRS left, but he has the straight line advantage. Already, look at this, I can't believe it. What is that Alpine doing? Breaking in a straight line? I don't know what happened there. But that is John Mazer straight up into fourth position. Great stuff. Squares hadn't got an answer for him. Although he's sniffing his rear end down into the braking zone, trying to be as close as possible, but gets away with it. Sushi Trash now has made his way. Oh! Nice save. Nice save. Dangerous, I should say, has made his way to the back of this pack here. We'll go forward to him. He's going to get a double help into the DRS. What can he do? Wide open here as they gain on the car in front as they both pop out with a slipstream towards the braking zone. Squares is up the inside. Dangerous is there as well. John Mazer goes from fourth to sixth in one corner. And he decides to pit with that one to pull the undercut. So people's tyre strategies are definitely starting to come into respect at the moment. El Brando's just made a pit stop. He's cool beans in 17th. But everyone else in front, though, still has to make their stop. Except for Nimble. He's got one out of the way. Interesting. Strategy's going to be interesting moving forward. There we go. So half the field really finished their stops. Some others are still out there. As Dangerous gets a fantastic run, he decides to pop back into the slipstream to get that DRS wide open. And he pulls out towards the braking zone. He's well clear, to be honest. Here we go. Look at that fantastic stuff from the Haas driver. And he gets it done even before the braking zone of turn 11, that is, ladies and gentlemen. So great stuff from the Haas driver here. It's lap 14 of 29. We're just about half distance. These drivers have been giving us some fantastic entertainment. And it's still going on. There's battles raging through the field. I don't know where to look. Leo Lund is in the pit lane now as well. So your race leader has decided now is the time to call the strategy. T for real. Somebody's in the wall out there. Yellow flag sector one. Dangerous. And Squares are still going hard at it. Dangerous is way more confidence. Look at that, up the inside. Thank you, bam, bam, thank you, man. Great move, absolutely textbook. The McLaren comes out with Leo Lund just in front as well, so good stuff from himself. Clement Pheasant has had a bit of a whoop-de-woo out there. Yellow flags, sector 1, 2, and 3. We have a VSC. I'm assuming it's a VSC, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it is. So, interesting stuff. People are going to get a bit of a free pit stop here. Bush. Oh, where's Bush at? Is he going to get around to get that pit stop? I'm not quite sure. Hasn't really worked out for him in the front. Although we could do 2 seconds point and move the one for El Brando under the BSC. Oh, never good. Never good. Where did he get that too? I don't know where he was on the track. Anyway, we won't worry about it. Is Bushyant going to come in? He has to. Any advantage on Leo Lund is going to be brilliant. So look at this. Drive-through penalty. For Nick it was. Oh my word, I thought Bosciant got that coming into the pit lane. But there we go. So the green flag just is waved as he came into the pit lane. So where's Leo Lund going to be at? Leo Lund is being passed by Mitchick Smurk down into turn. Into the second last corner. No, yes he is on the rear. Oh, look at this unbelievable stuff. So these guys really pushing hard here. I can't believe it. Mitchick Smurk has made the undercut work fantastically well for himself here. But I think Bosciant is way out in the lead now. Yes he is. He's already back out into the track and he's gained about 6 seconds on Leo Lund through that VSC pit stop situation. So can the cars second and third now work together to catch Bosciant, or is Bosciant going to be able to keep that advantage, keep that momentum and come away with the race win? It's going to be all right here right now, ladies and gentlemen. It's lap 16 of 29. As you rejoin myself here in the commentary booth, Leo Lund is still in second, coming under increasing pressure from Mitchick Smurk. But Mitchick Smurk doesn't quite have the steam down the back straight this time to try it on, but he's going to try and concentrate on some good lap times here to put the pressure on Leo Lund perhaps. Leo Lund is only 3% of his DRS left, ERS as you say. Mitchick Smurk is 20, is 3, in third as 32%. I don't know what's going on here. But yeah, there we go. Dangerous in fourth. Still hasn't made his pit stop. He's praying for a safety car. Is it going to happen for him? Who knows? It's a quite a long race here, ladies and gentlemen. There's still 17 cars in it. This guy is showing some fantastic stuff out there. I think El Brando might have had a bit of a little slipperoo. Yes, he's into the wall. Unfortunately for himself. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, as I just said it, ladies and gentlemen, I think the safety car has been deployed. Unbelievable stuff. What is that? The commentator's curse. I have no idea. Unbelievable stuff. But that is the safety car, ladies and gentlemen, has been deployed here in the Prospecty Racing League. It's round six. It's Miami. It's lap 17 of 29. And it's myself, Lemony Tang, in the commentary booth. But yeah, unbelievable stuff with that one. I can't believe it. And we this safety car period is brought to you by the Prospecty Racing League. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Prospecty Racing League. You can see us on ESTV, and our Season 7 Championship has kicked underway as well. Get involved. Get in contact, like and subscribe to the channel, and check out the Discord as well. So as you can see here, there's full grids, ladies and gentlemen. There's 4 tiers in PlayStation, 2 tiers in PC, tiers in Xbox as well. And we're also trying to expand into other series also. GT7 is out there. Assetto Corsa Competizione as well. So yeah, do get in contact, do check out the video here as we look in the background. Some fantastic battling from the Prospecty Racing League. I say it time and time again, you will not be disappointed. These guys are side by side with each other for most of the race. It's not hundreds, it's thousands of a second that we always say. Motorsport is a cruel mistress though, so these guys do get themselves into some incidents and accidents out there as well. But it's the same for the guys in real life. And that's what we want to promote here for the Prospecty Racing League. So as we leave him to it here, don't forget to check out the channel, like and subscribe, get on board at the Discord, check us out on the ESTV as well. I'm Lemony Tang. Have a great one. In the commentary booth, ladies and gentlemen, the race leaders have been picked up from the safety car now. The crocodile is starting to get longer behind. People are coming for another set of hards, I believe. Hards and mediums. So let's see how these strategies are going to pay off for each other. The top four have not come in and made a second stop, but Arrows has in fifth. And that should have worked out very well for Dangerous. Look at that on his brand new set of mediums. We said it before the safety car. He was praying for one and he got one in the end. And that is him sorted back into fourth position in contention for the race win here this evening. We have Arrows in fifth. Ultimately, again, is going to be in contention on them. Tires, look at this. Let's have a look at the different tires, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I don't know. Dangerous on mediums, Arrows on soft. Could get tasty towards the end here. Definitely. Nimble in sixth. On 11, Lapo mediums. He might live to regret. Expect the safety car to be in at the end of this lap as well. Cars making their way past the start finish line as the safety car comes onto one of the back straights. He'll be right on board with Nimble in the Aston Martin. Trying to save some fuel at the moment for these guys. I'm sure there's a few of them starting to panic. Yeah, they didn't get that safety car. They wanted to start doing a bit of fuel saving sooner rather than later. Lap 19 to 29. If you don't have enough fuel in the car, you can do as many laps as you want. If you can't finish the last one, you're getting nil pois. Big news under the safety car there as well. El Brando has been disqualified from the session. He overtook the race leader and the safety car without permission. And he has been disqualified for ignoring yellow flags. Very frustrating situation though, I have to say. You know, you have a couple of spins, the leaders overtake you, lap you, and then you're stuck a lap down for the rest of the race where you could potentially have a solid points paying position, you know. So anyway, what are you meant to do? So the safety car is coming down into the braking zone here. I think we're going to have another lap, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately for us. But it is only fair, the cars behind it didn't quite catch up in time. So you get to hear me ramble on even more in the commentary too. Absolutely great stuff for you guys. So the qualifying winner there, pole position, was Leo Lund. He's in second at the moment. He had second. In second position on the front row was Dangerous. He had an incident at the start of the race, not his fault, and he also got spun around mid-race, but he's found himself in fourth. Oh my word, Arrows nearly threw it into the wall. You were on board with him there, ladies and gentlemen. He definitely nearly threw that into the wall. And then we have Mitch Smurk, qualified in third, is in third at the moment. Very good stuff from himself. Mitchie Smoke does have a penalty. John Mazer has a penalty. Nick with a drive through. Absolute disaster for him. Bushy Ants is up 5 positions. Great stuff. Damien is up 5 positions. Oh, sorry, 7 positions. And someone's got spooked. Great stuff on this. I was pretty delighted with that one. Well, I would anyway if it was Bushy Ants in pole position in the lead. But there you go. Squares is down in 13. Down 6. Sinner in 14th, down 5, and Clement down 5. You know, they could have done a bit better here this evening so far, but that's what this safety car has brought these guys, a little bit of chance of redemption for them out there. It's not all over till the fat lady sings, and there's lap 20 out of 29. It'll be 21 out of 29 when we come back to green flag racing. The safety car is in this lap. Race control has confirmed it. And a Bushy Ants now takes over the honour, basically, of being the safety car, dictating the pace of the cars behind. No sudden movements on that throttle or brake at this moment in time, anyway. You know, you need to be fairly accessible to the guys behind. But it's up to him when he wants to accelerate off and bring this race back to green flag racing. He still hasn't done it yet. Still packing the pack up, and he's gone now. He's definitely thrown the anchor out now, brought it up, so he's brought the grid back to full speed racing. Leo Lund pops out into the braking zone, but he decides better of it, and everyone else starts to pile into the braking zone. The Alfa Romeo into the side of another car again. I can't believe it. It's like deja vu of the start of the race as they start to pile themselves through towards turns 4 and 5. How can they get through now? Through here, yellow flag out there. But they seem to get through so far, so good. I don't know. Is that dangerous that's been taken out again from an Alfa Romeo? I don't know what the story is. Is that one absolute disaster? But look at this. Damien is right on the back of John Mazer now. What a great bit of a run. Slipstream out. But John Mazer's on them softs. Who else on them softs? Let's have a look. Who has them nice sticky softs at the moment? Arrows does a bit of a change back there. But there's still stuff. Very close. What's this? Oh no. Oh no, that's Clement Pheasant. Clement is unfortunately locked at the moment. So, not good for himself. What was that? Who's that going slow down the back straight? What's that happening there? I have no idea. A bit of a weird one there. Leo Lund is still in second. Busciance is in first. But Pit Dodge Central. People locking up into them braking zones right now. They're really pushing hard. Dangerous is up the inside of Sinner. I tell you now, Sinner's dead. Oh no, that's the Martins around. That's got spooked. He has no front wing. Oh, who else is that? Absolute madness out there. Got spooked. 5 second penalty for speeding in the pit lane. It goes from bad to worse for got spooked as we have a look at Mitchix Murk trying to catch the race leaders. But Leo Lund is in second position behind Busciance. It's worked out very well for these guys, actually, I have to say, so far. The guys behind haven't really been able to make much of a dent on them, although Dangerous did get taken out. But that's parcel of racing side by side between the Aston Martin and the Williams here as they are closing up. People glitching left right as well. I'm not quite sure what's happening there. John Mazer makes the move, though, on Nimble. Great stuff from himself. Mitchix Murk is down into fourth. Did he have a spin or something? No, Arrows has made the move on him. Alright then, so Arrows is really starting to fly now on these soft tyres. Can he cane and catch the race leaders? I think he might be able to. Let's have a look. So Arrows indicating a Mitchix Murk behind. Bit of a weird one. Blue flags are out left, right and centre. I don't know what the story is of that one. To come down here. Oh no, Leo Lund is after going wide. I can't believe it. Lund has gone wide. Arrows is in third. And then what is after happening? Busciance is in third. Arrows has just taken the race lead. We have a yellow flags out there. Another safety car. Absolute disaster. And he doesn't pick up the leaders either. Oh, lovely. Absolutely brilliant, Codemasters. Absolute disaster. What happened there? Busciance is now in third and Leo Lund is in sixth position. We missed it in the commentary field. Absolutely kicking myself with that one. As everyone else behind trying to take advantage of this safety car. But yeah, absolute disaster, ladies and gentlemen. This safety car is brought to you by the Prospects E-Racing League and Lemony Tang. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and follow the Prospects E-Racing League on Twitter. It's myself, Lemony Tang, in the commentary booth every single week. It's an absolute pleasure. Don't forget to check us out on ESTV. As always, Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Prospects E-Racing League. You can see us on ESTV, and our Season 7 Championship has kicked underway as well. Get involved, get in contact, like and subscribe to the channel, and check out the Discord as well. So as you can see here, there's full grids, ladies and gentlemen. There's 4 tiers in PlayStation, 2 tiers in PC, tiers in Xbox as well. And we're also trying to expand into other series also. GT7 is out there. Assetto Corsa Competizione as well. So yeah, do get in contact. Do check out the video here as we look in the background. Some fantastic battling from the Prospects E-Racing League. I say it time and time again, you will not be disappointed. These guys are side by side with each other for most of the race. It's not hundreds, it's thousands of a second that we always say. Motorsport is a cruel mistress though, so these guys do get themselves into some incidents and accidents out there as well. But it's the same for the guys in real life, and that's what we want to promote here for the Prospect Z Racing League. So as we leave him to it here, don't forget to check out the channel, like and subscribe, get on board at the Discord, check us out on the ESTV as well. I'm Lemony Tang, have a great one. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Coach's Boot here. Bushy Yance is still your race leader, although everyone behind has now got soft. Unbelievable stuff here. Mitchie Smurkers in second, Arrows in third, Damien in fourth, John Mazer in fifth, Nimble in sixth, Dangerous is in seventh, Squares is in eighth at the moment, Sushi Trash is in ninth, Damien is in 10th, Sinner is in 11th, Leo London 12th, Nick is in 13th, Scott Spooked is in 14th, T for Real is in 15th, and Clement Pheasant is in 16th. I pretty much mean this, ladies and gentlemen. I called out the names of everyone who could possibly win this Grand Prix. It is totally undecided who it is going to be. I hope the safety car is coming in at the end of this lap. I'm not quite sure. I think Godspook is still a bit behind. So we've got one more lap, ladies and gentlemen. It will be lap 26. We'll have a four-lap shootout, hopefully, towards the end of this race to settle it. Settle it with the lads and lassies out there. Who's it going to be? Get in contact with me on the old chat, ladies and gentlemen. Who's going to be your race winner here? Who's it going to be? I'm going to say Dangerous. Dangerous, I'm telling you. If you could do it, buddy, you've been spun twice. Nearly crashed about four times in this race. Crashed into, crashed out of, you know what I mean? Absolute unbelievable stuff. That ass is still in one piece. I would be amazed. But he's in seventh at the moment. He's giving it a good go. But Arrows is definitely someone who's going to try it out there. Hello to Ronaldo out there. What's the story, buddy? So, definitely going to be coming back to the green flag racing by the end of this lap. I wonder if there's anyone still with some fuel issues out there. Everyone has a red fuel. Ooh. There for quite a lot of this race, and I don't know, we don't know what happened, but seven Bushy Ants found themselves in a bit of bother. Get these rear tires going. Oh no, he's around! I can't believe it, Leo Lund. What is the story? Everyone was backing up there. You were just trying to weave your tires too much, and now you find yourself in 14th instead of 12th. Well, learn that lesson, ladies and gentlemen. We've all done it before, we all know it, we've all done it. Anyway, safety car's back in the end of this lap. Bushy Ants is in first position. It's his job to tell the field when to go racing now. He takes over the job of the safety car. It's up to him when to accelerate. He doesn't need to do anything too much out of the box here. He doesn't need to reinvent the wheel. But Leslie comes around the left-hander. He's throttled it at the moment. I can't believe it. Mitchie Smurkers being caught up there. There's a lapped car in the way, so it's absolutely going to be causing some mad stuff into the turn one braking zone. Everyone seems to be getting through nicely for now. I don't know where to look. People are inside and outside of cars as well. Mitchie Smurkers get a 5-second penalty for ignoring a yellow flag. I don't know how you do that. But anyway, passing under the safety car, maybe. I don't know. The lapped car is throwing the guys a bit of a curveball out here this evening. But as we go through onto the back straight now, the lap cars need to get out of the way of the cars on the lead lap, I think. That's what the thing is here. people getting in the way of everyone else, going to distract people in the braking zones. Anyway, Leo Lund is making a move back there, but we jump back towards the race lead. I'm not quite sure where the action's going to be. Into the braking zone, they all go now. Is that three wide? It is indeed. Look at that. That's got spooked up the inside of Nick. And that is Leo Lund in 12th position just there as well. So interesting stuff from them. They all got away with it so far, as they pile through turns 15 and 16 onto the back straight now. This is where it's all going to get tasty down into the braking zone. This is the camera angle we want to see. We're looking at the leaders. Arrows decides better of it. But as the rest of the field start to pile into the braking zone, does anyone take it down the inside? The McLaren of Leo Lund is trying it on Sinner. Yes, indeed, and he's made the move stick. Great stuff indeed from Leo Lund. He's up into 11. The comeback kid is trying it on here once again. What can he do? As Damien and Nimble are side by side here, this is gonna end up in tears. Look at this. Squares is right there as well. And up the inside goes Dangerous. So Dangerous throwing himself caution to the wind here. Choose 4 and 5 they go. Great racing from everyone out here. Very close, very action-packed here. Last 2 or 3 laps. Oh no, the Ferrari of Arrows is around. I can't believe it. That is one of the race contenders out of this Grand Prix onto the front straight. Not a good situation. But that's him out of the races. The rest of the field start to go towards turns 11. What can they do into the braking zone? Not looking too bad. Oh, the McLaren's, look at this, up the inside of the out. Look at that McLaren. McLaren car park through there. Everyone getting away from it nicely. Look at this. Everyone kind of holding themselves up here. The battle is raging all the way through this field. How are they going to get down into the braking zone now? We'll wait and see as they momentarily, they come onto the back straight here. Flat out now, ERS is wide open for Dangerous behind Squares. What can he do into the braking zone? Is he going to try and pop out? He does. Can he make the move stick in there? Yes, he's up there anyway. He doesn't quite give Dangerous much move. Much room between these two drivers, but they make the move stick, and what a fantastic stuff from Squares. Great defending. He didn't give that up at all, and he was giving each other room. Very good stuff. As we start the penultimate lap, ladies and gentlemen, it's still Bushy Ants in the race lead. Mitchix Morgan's in second. Nimble is in third. Squares and Dangerous are battling hard here for fourth and fifth. And the battles rage through the field here. John Mazur's behind Damien as well. Leo Lund is just there in 8th also, so he's made his way up a lot of them positions there. He's in 8th now. Last time we looked at him, he was in, oh, he's trying it on there as well. He was in 11th, I think it was. Coming onto the back straight now. Dangerous is right up the backside now of the car in front. What can he do into the braking zone? He pulls out. He's deep in there and he makes the move stick, but the Albin keeps it in there. The Squares is still there. Dangerous though. Oh, look at this. Bodum giving no quarts for anyone. Oh, they're both into the wall. Oh my word, what is that all about? As he spins himself around and sorts himself out, passes also into the wall. So there we go. It goes from bad to worse for these guys. And unfortunately, some tempers might be flared after that one. As Leo Lund finds himself into fifth position now. What a fantastic maneuver on John Mazur as they come into the braking zone here. Man, oh, so great stuff from everyone out there. Fantastic race, and it's really hard. All right, Bushy's on the last lap now. As Nimble is up the inside. For second position, great stuff from Nimble. He's made the move stick. Got spooked, has crashed unfortunately out there in his DNF. But Bushy Ants starts the last lap here. We have, oh, the Alpine just spun in a straight line. I can't believe what we just witnessed. Unfortunate for Squares. He keeps it going, but people are really starting to struggle. Look at this, Damien down the inside of the hassle. No foot wing, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen. Oh no! Arrows nearly into the wall there under acceleration. There's a car literally in the wall there. Leo Lund is up the around the outside. He's into fourth now. I tell you, moves all over this track. I don't know where to look. Where to look, I have no idea. Mitchix Murk is back into second position with Nimble in third. Oh, loosey goosey from Nimble. but I think it's going to be Bushy Ant's day today, ladies and gentlemen. He's onto the back straight, and he has no one around him. Squares has crashed, unfortunately, as well. It was a strong race until the last lap. As you say, you can be doing well, but you have to finish the last lap. But Mitchick's Murk has, or Nimble has no answer for Mitchick's Murk and Bushy Ant. So Bushy Ant comes through the second last corner. In the last corner, it's going to be Ant who wins the Grand Prix this evening. No doubt about it. I can't believe it. What an absolute legend. He smashed it out of park and he wins the Grand Prix this evening. Nimble is in second and Leo Lund is in third as the rest of the field start to sort themselves out. But unbelievable stuff from Bushy Ant. I'm trying to take that down. Absolutely, Bushy Ant wins the Grand Prix. Tell you now, Nimble is in second. Great stuff from Nimble. Can't believe it. But what a fantastic Grand Prix we have witnessed here this evening. We need to catch me breath, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure you guys are too. Back at base. Unbelievable stuff. We wait for the race winners to come out onto the podium now. But that's Bushy Ant who steers himself into the winning position this evening and steers himself onto the podium. The trophy is waved high and proudly for everyone to see out there. Absolutely great stuff. And the champagne is flowing. It's an absolute fantastic day. It's Bushy Ant's day. It's Alpine's day. He was the one who made the least amount of mistakes. He's the one who crossed the line first and he's the one who gets the prize this evening. Absolutely amazing stuff. But we had Nimble in second there and then Leo Lund in third. Unfortunately, what a great comeback from Leo though. I tell you now, that's going to be one for the record books, maybe, perhaps, or a highlight reel for sure. But that's being Bushy Ant, your race winner. Nimble is in second. Leo Lund rounds out your podium, ladies and gentlemen. But Damien in fourth with Sushi Trash in fifth. John Mazur is in sixth with Mitchick's Murk in seventh. BRT Arrows in 8th, not a good day for himself there. Dangerous in 9th, again another mare of a day. Damien in 10th, Sinner in 11th, Nick in 12th. Then we have Squares in 13th, didn't quite make the end. Clement Pheasant in 14th, T for Real in 15th, Got Spooked in 16th, and then El Brando in 17th. Winners and losers here this evening, but Bushy Ant is your race winner. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is myself from the commentary booth this evening. It's been an absolute cracker, as always, for the Prospects E-Racing League. That was round 6. It was from Miami. And it's been myself, Lemony Tang, in the commentary booth this evening, as always. Leo Lund got quali. Damien in second with Mitchick's Murk in third. But when the checkered flag fell, Bushy Ant is your race winner with Nimble in second. And Leo Lund gets a deserved podium. But unbelievable stuff from Prospects E-Racing League, the Tier 1 PC. Don't forget to check us out on ESTV, ladies and gentlemen. And later on this evening, in about 40 minutes time, you will see the one and only Prospects E-Racing League Tier 1 from PlayStation. Don't miss it out. Do check it out. It's going to be an absolute cracking race, as always, for the Prospects E-Racing League. I'm Lemony Tang. Have a great evening. E.